Defender Europe 20 was designed to build strategic readiness through exercising our ability to rapidly deploy a large, combat-credible force and, together with our NATO allies and partners, respond to any crisis. The multinational exercise was intended to strengthen partnerships, build strategic readiness within the alliance, enhance interoperability, and deter potential adversaries. It was also slated to be the largest movement of military personnel and equipment from the U.S. to Europe in more than 25 years. After more than 2 years of planning and preparation, the operational portion of Defender Europe 20 began in February. Equipment from the United States arrived by sea vessels at several strategic ports in Europe, while personnel began to arrive at various locations across the continent. Some U.S. forces arrived fully equipped, while others began to draw from Army pre-positioned stocks after arrival, and then move via convoy, rail, line haul, and barge to various training areas for linked exercises. However, the COVID-19 outbreak and ensuing pandemic forced major modifications of the exercise in both size and scope. All movement of personnel and equipment from the United States to Europe was halted in early March, with the health, safety, and readiness of personnel remaining the primary concern. COVID-19 mitigation measures became the top priority for U.S. and participating ally and partner nations. As a precautionary measure, several Defender Europe 20 linked exercises were not conducted. In early June, phase one of the modified Defender Europe 20 began with the linked exercise Allied Spirit. Approximately 6,000 U.S. and Polish soldiers participated in Allied Spirit, which included a river crossing at Drawsko-Pomorskie Training Area, Poland. Military equipment was originally moved from APS sites in Germany and Belgium to Bergen-Hohn Training Area, Germany, in February as part of the original Defender Europe 20 exercise. In July, the 18th Military Police mounted the Trophy system on several Abrams tanks. Trophy is an active protection system that is designed to detect and defeat rocket-propelled grenades, recoilless rifles, and anti-tank guided missiles. The fielding of Trophy systems provided the U.S. Army's logistics teams with the opportunity to assess and experience the dynamics of moving and installing the system in a field environment. Once testing was complete, the Trophy systems were removed, and the tanks were moved to Drawsko-Pomorskie Training Area in Poland for the second phase of the modified exercise. Phase two of the modified Defender Europe 20 exercise began in mid-July and ran through mid-August. It had three main objectives: a dynamic force employment of a U.S. Army unit to Poland, drawing and fielding of equipment from Army pre-positioned stock, and the execution of a company-level combined live-fire exercise. A U.S.-based Combined Arms Battalion conducted a Dynamic Force Employment, or DFE, to Europe. A DFE is a Department of Defense-directed strategic deployment designed to test the Army's ability to rapidly alert and deploy around the globe. Approximately 550 soldiers from Fort Hood, Texas, participated in the exercise. As the Army prepares for Defender Europe 21, we continue to build on the strategic readiness developed during Defender Europe 20. Defender Europe 21 will focus on integration with our allies and partners across the Black Sea and Balkans regions, and is anticipated to include training events across more than a dozen countries.